When Blender is first opened, the user interface opens with the Layout Workspace showing. The Layout Workspace consists of a header and four windows, sometimes called viewports. Here the header is outlined in yellow, and the four windows are outlined in red, green, blue, and violet. The header and the four windows are joined together to form one layer. The header is at the top and has five drop-down menus, typical of what you would see with other computer programs: File, Edit, Render, Window, and Help. To the right of these menus are several workspaces. These are preset combinations of windows. Layout is the workspace you see upon opening Blender. In the Layout workspace, the large window outlined here in red is the 3D Editor window. This is where you will do most of your modeling. The 3D Editor window has two panels, one on the right and one on the left. The panel on the right is called the Properties panel and is hidden by default. The panel can be viewed by hovering the mouse cursor over the 3D Editor window and using the keyboard shortcut, the N key. Using the N key again toggles the panel to be hidden. The panel on the left is called the Toolbar and is visible by default. The toolbar can be hidden by hovering the mouse cursor over the 3D Editor window and using the keyboard shortcut, the T key. To the right of the 3D Editor window are two windows. The upper window is called the Outline window. It contains a list of all the objects in your scene. In the opening default scene, there are three objects: a cube, a camera, and a light. To select an object, select the name in the Outline window. Cube selected, camera selected, and light selected. Alternatively, you can select the object in the 3D Editor window. The object will be outlined in yellow. To select more than one object, hold down the Shift key. The last selected object is called the active object and will be outlined in yellow. The other objects will be outlined in orange. You can select all objects in a scene by using the keyboard shortcut, the A key. Clicking the A key twice deselects all selected objects. You can also click anywhere in the 3D Editor window, other than on an object, to deselect all selected objects. The lower right-hand window is the Properties window. Here you can set parameters for the scene. For example, under the Scene Properties tab, you can open the unit's chevron and change from metric to imperial measurement. Finally, at the bottom of the user interface is the Timeline window. This window is used for animating your scene, something you will not be doing when you first start to model in Blender to make Trainz assets.